Hello everyone, this video will discuss on the NET December 2018 paper number 2. The question is, a binary search tree is constructed by inserting the following number in order 60, 25, 72, 15, 30, 68, 101, 13, 18, 47, 70, 34. The number of nodes is the left subtree is option number A 3, 6, 7 and 5. To solve this question, we will see what is the binary search tree. Binary search tree is a tree in which every left child has less value than their parent and every right child has greater value than their parent. So here root has always higher middle value. Left subtree always has less values than the root and right subtree has always greater value than the root. So left subtree of a node contains only values less than root. Right subtree of a node contains only greater values of the node than the node. The left and right subtree each must also be a binary search tree. We will solve this using a binary search tree. The values are 60. First value is 60. So in the binary search tree, first value is 60. Second value is 25. If the value is less than root, it has to be inserted at the left side. If the value is greater than the root, it has to be inserted at the right side. So next value is 25. It is less than root, so we will insert it at the left side. Next value is 72. It is greater than root, so we will insert it at the right side of the root. Next value is 15. So from the root, go up to the left side. Again, it is less than 25, so again go to the left side. Next value is 30. From the root, it is the left side. From the 25, it is greater value, so it will be inserted at the right side of the root. Next value is 68. From the root, it is the greater value, so it has to be inserted at the right part. But at the right part, we have value 72. 72 is greater than this value, so we will insert it as the left side. Next value is 101. From the root, we have to be inserted at the right side. Again, 101 has greater value, so it has to be inserted at the again right part of this. Next value is 30. From root, left side. Again, left side, again it is less than 15, so it has to be inserted here. Next value is 18. From root, left, left, and now right side. Next value is 47. From the root, again come at the left part. From the left part, again come at the right part. Again here it is the greater than 30, so insert it at the right side. Next value is 70. Come at the right side. 70 is less than 72, so come at the left side. Again, from the 68, it is greater value, so come at the right part of this. Next value is 34. From the root, come at the left, come at the right, come at the right, come at the left. So in this way, binary search tree will be generated. Binary search tree will be generated with the given values. Now the question is, the number of nodes in the left subtree are. Here the first value is called as the root. Whatever the values at the left part of the root is called as the left subtree. The values at the right side of the root are as called as right subtree. Left subtree contains 7 nodes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 nodes. Whereas right subtree contains only the 4 nodes. Our question is, the number of nodes in the left subtree is 7. So correct option is C, 7. We can see again the diagram of this. Here the colored part shows the left subtree. So correct, we can count the left subtree values here, total 7. So our correct option is option number C, 7. Next question is, 4 byte IP address consist of both network and host address. Host address, neither network nor host address, network address. This question is on the topic IP address. So we will see first what is the IP address. So this question is on IPv4 address. IP address, IPv4 address is 32-bit IP address. So it is 32-bit address. These 32 bits is divided into the 4 groups of 8 bits, separated by dot. So this is 8-bit, 8-bit, again 8-bit, and again 8-bit, separated by dot. So it is 8-bit, 8-bit, 8-bit and 8-bit. So this is total 32-bit IP address. This 32-bit total IP address contains two parts. First part contains network address. Second part contains host address. It is also called as net ID or host ID. There are 5 types of classful addressing: class A, class B, class C, class D and class E, which contain net ID as well as host ID, combinedly called as IP address. Net ID in a class A is 8-bit and host ID is 24-bit. In class B, it is 16-bit net ID and 16-bit host ID. C addressing 24-bit net ID and 8-bit host ID. This address is stored as or used as multicasting. And this class E address is reserved for the future use. It is all about the IP address. So IP address is nothing but 32-bit IP address contains the 4 groups which contain all net ID and host ID. Net ID means network address, host ID means host address. So we will see our question again. The 4 byte IP address consists of, our correct answer is both network and host address. So option number A is the correct answer. In Linux operating system environment, which command is used to print a line? PR, LPR, PTR and print. In the Linux operating system, first 2 commands are used for the printing. First command is PR, which is used to set the formatting of the file, or this helps the formatting of the file. And LP or LPR command is printing a document on a default printer. So here PR command is for the formatting of the printing and LPR is for the printing of a file. So our correct answer is option number B, LPR command is used to print a file. Option number B. Data scrubbing is the given options. A process to upgrade the quality of data after it is moved into a data warehouse. A process to upgrade the quality of data before it is moved into a data warehouse. A process to load the data in the data warehouse and to create the necessary indexes. A process to reject the data from the data warehouse and to create the necessary indexes. The question is on the topic data warehouse. When we are transferring the data in the data warehouse, we have to do some necessary operations before it. So one of the operation is data scrubbing, which has to be performed before the data is moved into the data warehouse. So what is the data scrubbing? Data scrubbing is nothing but upgrading the quality of data. So the data scrubbing is a process to upgrade the quality of data before it is moved in a data warehouse. So our correct answer is option number B. Next question is, which system call creates new process in Unix? This is very straightforward question. In a Unix operating system, fork is a system call which create a new process. So our answer is option number A, fork is a system call which create new process in the Unix. Thank you. For the next video, kindly subscribe the channel.